Hello everyone, Gift of Soul here. So today I have for you my top 5 used Oracle decks for 2018. I was about to say 2017 because that is when I started embracing my gift and started buying decks. My collection in some eyes may not be big, but to me that is a lot of decks in my collection. So it took me a while to actually pick which ones, not even the top 5 used, but my top 5 favorites. I mean, it could be top 5 used, whatever you think, I don't know. But so I do have them next to me, and so I'm just gonna go in the, it's not even in order, but I'm just gonna go in the order that I have them stacked, and I guess go through some of the cards and let you know why I like the deck, or why I use it so much, or what I use it for. So let's get started. So the first one is Energy Oracle by Sandra Ann Taylor. It's a 53 card deck and guidebook. This deck, I don't know, first of all, my favorite color is blue, so that may have played a part in me getting it. The box was very attractive. There was some things that drew me away from getting the deck, but I still, the good outweighed the bad, so I got it. So there is the guidebook. It has affirmations for each card. So they also have reversed meanings, a general meaning. The cards are numbered. So yeah, it's a pretty good guidebook. I do use it every now and then. I get to where I don't need it anymore for this deck. So yeah, I've had this, well, all except for one of these decks I have had since last year, and this is one that I've had since last year. So there is the back. So it is reversible, and the back drew me to it as well. Some of the time, or most of the time, shall I say, I am one that, you know, watches some of the reviews and get a look at the cards before I purchase, because I have to be drawn to, the images are the biggest part of the cards, and a lot of people, for some reason don't focus on that. It's all about the words to some people, but, for me, the images are a big part, and without the images, there really wouldn't be any cards. So, anyhow, so that is the back, and I'm just going to go through a few of them here. I have a full flip through already on my channel, so you can check that out. So the cards are numbered. These aren't in order because I've used them a lot, and I am currently working with them. So, the numbers are at the top in gold. It has a gold little border. And then you have the keywords that is in white font, but it's in a green box. That is what drew me away from it. I don't know if it was the color green or what it was, but it kind of takes away from the image. So that is initially why I almost didn't get the deck. So it is obviously good for energy work. It does work with chakras and your archangels, which I am about to start working more with. I felt called to work more with crystals now, and also to work more with chakras. So this is Adjacent Possibilities, and number 32, Door to Spirit. 34, door to personal healing and happiness. Number 2, journey. I have also done pick a cards with this on my channel. 19, rest and rejuvenation. 35, first chakra, Archangel Michael. Archangel Michael is, I almost just got him mixed up with Raphael, but yeah. So, Archangel, fourth chakra, Archangel Raphael is turned upside down, so it's reversed. Number 35, Archangel Raphael is about traveling, being protected on your travels. Yeah, things like that. Man holding a coin. I'm gonna show just a few more here. Attachment, contract, that is about making something official. Man holding a heart. Fifth chakra, Archangel Gabriel. And a thinking woman. I think that these could be used. I mean, this video could be just about the ones that I've worked with the most this year so far. Right now, I've been working with this a little bit more, so if I can get it closed. Okay. So there's the energy oracle. I'm gonna get that out the way. And so this is one that I bought this year, Wisdom of the Oracle by Colette Baron Reed. It's a 52 card deck and it comes with a guidebook. So this deck I was excited to get, but at the same time I was like, how can I use this deck? But when I got it, I started, you know, working with it. And let me just tell you, while this is an oracle deck, this is very, very, very punch you in your face accurate. And I don't know if anybody else has said that about this deck, but in my experience, even with doing it for other clients and even pulling cards for my family members, they are amazed and I am amazed. Like, I literally tell someone, if you want a card pulled from this deck, you better think twice, because it's a nicer way of telling you what you don't want to hear. The very first message card I pulled out of here, it resonated with me so strongly to the point where I almost threw the deck down. Because obviously we all get stuff we don't want to hear. And I don't know, I just wanted to disconnect from it because it was that accurate. But then I said, nope, we're going to go ahead and work with you. So, okay. Inside is blue. There's looks like some scuff marks in mine. I don't know how they got there, but that is the guidebook. Very chunky indeed for a 52 card deck, you would expect it to be. I didn't get the gilded version. This was the only version I saw available where I purchased it. I get most of my decks, if not actually majority of them, Energy Oracle came from Amazon, but most of my other decks, aside from a few, came from eBay. You have to be careful more so buying stuff on eBay, though, especially decks, because some will have them labeled as new and sealed, and then they come all beat up and bruised and obviously used. So do be careful and make sure you proofread and double check the item description before you buy. I'm pretty sure it's the same for Amazon, but eBay has a very bad habit of sending you a used item or false advertising. So do watch out for that.
So this is the back.
So again, I did not get the gilded version. If you can see in those little circles and white typing font, it says ask and know. So but yeah, I'm just going to show you some here. This deck is good for anything. I do think it can be used for light working as well. So there are numbers, I think they're all numbered at the top right hand corner. I'm not sure. So Treasure Island, and I love the keywords. The keywords are very unique. Soulmates, number 41. I only use reversals if the creator intended for the cards to be reversed, or if they have reversal meanings in the book, which this does not. So if it doesn't come with reversals, I don't use it that way, because I feel like I'm discrediting the creator in some way. So I try to use it for the way that they intended it to be used. So 25, round and round. 45, time to go. I think this was one of the first, if not the first card that I ever got pulled for myself from this deck. And I did have a specific situation question in person in my mind, and this popped up and I was like, no, I'm gonna get another card because this is not what I wanted to hear. And then it just kept on pulling cards about the same thing, telling me the same thing over and over and over again. I'm like, okay, just take it for what it is and accept it for now. So 49, Observer. Go the Distance. Exchanging Gifts. I think that's the first one that I pulled for my mother. Well, my mother pulled it for herself, but A Leg Up. So the keywords are very fascinating and they're unique. You're not getting, you know, your standard words. So that's another reason why I like this. Orphaned. Chaos and Conflict. Between Worlds. This card I just literally pulled for a client reading just a moment ago before I started this video. And what this is about something or somebody in your life to teach you a lesson. So let's pull just a few more. Message in a Bottle. I love the color scheme. Even the darker ones, they're appealing to look at. I don't know, this is just an overall nicer way of telling you what you don't want to hear. Fork in the Road. Deep Knowing. Loyal Heart. Clean It Up. Blessed. In one of my favorites, All That Glitters. So I'm going to just tell you a little bit about the guidebook. Again, I do have a full flip through and review on my channel. I think it's still up. I don't know, because I got rid of a few other videos that I didn't like the way I did them. But so table of contents. About the cards. It gives you a little note from Colette Baron Reed. How it works. I'll be glad when I get this freaking thing fixed. Sorry. preparation for a reading. A couple of spreads. Okay, and then you have the card, black and white representation, The card number is also at the top of the page. So each card has a different set of meanings. You have the essential meanings for the card, the oracle's message, a relationship message, prosperity message, and a protection message. So that is the guidebook. Very chunky indeed. It obviously more than likely has information about her, yes, at the back. So that is the Wisdom of the Oracle. I almost said Doreen Virtue. I don't know why. By Colette Mary. So, and there you go again. I don't know what's wrong with you today. Okay, so now on to some decks from a creator that a lot of people in this type of community tend to stray away from. Now, this person had a conversion last year, but what people didn't get was she was always a follower of Jesus. She just made an announcement that she would become even more, like, a more devoted Christian, more conservative. From my perspective going in and first learning about Doreen Virtue, she was the first person that I felt drawn to get decks from at first, and I thought she was Christian the whole time, so I don't know what everybody's talking about or if I missed something, but I believe she was just saying she was going to become more devoted to the Christianity lifestyle. But from what I was seeing, she was already a follower of Jesus, so I don't know why people are shocked. But anyway, so that is Doreen Virtue. I personally still love her decks, and I don't have anything against her for wanting to be a better Christian. If it works for her and whoever else, it works for them. So, but yeah, so here we go. I think a lot of these are taken off. I mean, you can find them anywhere, I'm pretty sure, either way, but I think she's not selling on, or she's not partnering with Haystyles or Lifestyles anymore, so you might not be able to get a deck from them. I don't know, because I got literally almost every single last one of my decks on eBay. So so Romance Angels are Doreen Virtue. So these cards are kind of beat up. It's the number one that I use the most, so that might be why, especially for love questions. So we have the back. It was gold gilded, but the gold has faded because I have dead rifle shuffling with it eventually. So that is how it looks now. So as you can see, it's not your standard man and a woman on the top of the box. On the top of the box too, but on the back of the card it is two women, which I found very interesting and very unique about this deck. So the color scheme seems to be gold and like fuchsia, some type of pink, I don't know. So yeah, I'm just gonna show a few of the cards. And there's one that wanted to pop out. So getting to know each other. As you reveal your inner selves to each other, your bond deepens. So that is, the card has a main phrase, and then at the bottom it tells you overall what to expect for it to mean, I guess. So, honeymoon. Enjoy the bliss of this holiday time together. True love. This is the romance of a lifetime. codependency. This works for not only love and relationships, like in the romantic sense, it works for friends, family members, in self-love. So it's not just about love with other, love with a romantic partner. You deserve love. You are lovable. Romantic feelings. Soulmate, which is also the image on the card. This could be the one. You've already met the romantic partner you seek. Children, chemistry, deception. Someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship. Wedding, retreat. There's a couple more specifically I want to show you, so just give me 1 second. Release your ex. Free yourself. Pay attention to red flags. Unrequited love. And there's one more that I think is really beautiful. Let me find it. Well, two more. Stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. Let me find you. Three more, actually. Okay. Past life relationship. And here is the one that I was ultimately wanting to show you. Reconciliation. Someone from your past for returning to your life. We all want that card. Most of us do. But the image itself, not even the word. I'm more concerned about the image. I don't know what it is about it, but I love it. So, Burning Virtue Standard Guidebook. Main keyword, black and white representation of the card, and that's it. So, well, and obviously how to work with the cards and all that type of stuff. So, I guess these will be the most used ones of this year. Not necessarily my top favorite, but they are my favorites at the same time. So, which is why I'm using them like that. So I guess you could put it that way. And next we have Angel Answers by Doreen Virtue. Again, Doreen Virtue at first was all the decks I was buying when I first started collecting. And then eventually I got comfortable enough to venture out to other creators. So while I'm still a fan of Doreen Virtue, I am trying to exploit, that would have got me into some trouble. I was trying to explore other creators, so. But don't get me wrong, I'll probably still be getting some more of her decks. There are some on my wish list. So we have Angel Answers, Doreen Virtue, and Radley Valentine. Standard Doreen Virtue Guidebook. And here is the back. And I'm just going to go over a few. So you have no, remain positive, don't stop, forgiveness, you're ready, compromise, success, if you believe, recovery, unlikely, perfect timing, ask your angels, ask for help from others, communicate clearly, yes with an exclamation point. There is another yes card in here that doesn't have the exclamation point, and I think there's another no card in here with an exclamation point. So just a few more here. Be assertive. Let go. Helpful people. Choose a new direction. I have a full flip through of this on my channel as well, so the situation will improve. Look for a sign. Yes, without the exclamation point. Opportunity. Listen to your intuition. So, no need to flip through the guidebook. It's literally pretty much the same as that, except the meanings, the explanations are a lot shorter. That's really the only difference. So that was Angel Answers by Doreen Virtue and Radley Valentine. And the most used would be, and the words are faded off, it's because I guess of where I had it stored. I have them all stored in the same place, but at one point I did misplace this deck. About a month or so ago found it. I still have one that is missing, and I think that's long gone. I'm just gonna have to get a new one. But yeah. So Daily Guidance from Your Angels Oracle Cards by Doreen Virtue. Standard Doreen Virtue guidebook, except this one has additional meanings. Good for, it says daily, but honestly I find to work better with it for maybe a monthly card reading, or a one card draw weekly. Daily, I feel, would be too confusing, but monthly or weekly, I think is okay. And it can oftentimes answer specific questions. So there's the back. Gold gilding. Now, I have not rifle shuffled this, but it seems like the gold is fading now that I'm using it more, even though I'm not doing shuffling like that. Just gonna go through some trustworthy guidance. So as you can see, you've probably seen most of these cards because I've used them on the pick a card reading. So some of these you are familiar with. I have not yet did a full flip through or a review of this yet. So you can link it, not link it, but comment down below if you would like to see my full review and flip through. So trustworthy guidance, it has your image at the top, keyword right there, and then a passage at the bottom explaining what the angels want you to know, or what they feel like, I guess, resonates with you in your life at this time. And yes, it can actually answer specific questions, but I tend to try not to use it for that. So I use them more for an advice card. So you received a wonderful idea as an answer to your prayers. This idea is real and trustworthy. You can safely move forward with it, knowing that we are with you every step of the way. Ask for and be open to receiving our support for anything that you need related to this idea. Okay, so what do you desire? Joy. Ground yourself. When you detach from awareness of your body in the physical world, you become ungrounded. Although it's pleasant to float heavenward, your attention and work are needed upon the earth. We're helping you balance the spiritual and material so that you can enjoy a fulfilling earthly life. New partner. Let your past go. The ocean. Family. Cleanse and detoxify. Fresh air. Ask. Entrepreneur. Time to go. Go for it. Energy work. Reward yourself. So I'm just gonna go through a few more. I keep saying a few more and then I keep grabbing a whole handful of them. But so notice the signs. Acceptance. See yourself and others through the eyes of the angels with unconditional love and acceptance. In this way, you inspire and lift everyone to their highest potential. Heart chakra. Perfect timing, which is one of my favorite cards from this deck. Listen. Play. Opportunity to forgive. Now, I have been getting this a lot for myself, and I keep getting repeatedly cards about forgiveness now in any deck I pull from for myself. So it looks like I've got some forgiving to do, and trust me, I do. But anyway, the situation brings you the opportunity to heal, grow, and release negative patterns. Hold the intention of seeing the other person's inner divine light and goodness. We will help you release unforgiving thoughts, feelings, and energies and lift you to a higher place of peace and compassion. Yeah, I don't know why. I mean, I know why it keeps popping up, but I mean, I need time. Shower of abundance. That would be the card, I mean the image that is on the card. I don't think it's on the front of the box. It's not. It's some type of unicorn. Change in direction. Blessing in disguise. Release and surrender. Steady progress. So that was the daily guidance from your angel's oracle cards, by Doreen Virtue. So these were my top five used, and also they're kind of my favorites oracle decks. The ones that I'm honestly really using the most at this time. Except this one. This one I have just started to pick back up. So the rest of them I'm using like crazy right now. So anyways, that was it. If you would like to see another video regarding decks or anything really, just comment and let me know what you would like to see, because I'm running out of ideas. I'm going to be honest. And this is already 34 minutes long, just talking about five different decks, and I didn't even go through all of them. So, anyways, I apologize for it being so long. So I guess that is it. So top five, favorites in the most used for 2018, I guess. In terms of oracle decks. So yeah, I hope that you enjoyed the video. If you do, you can let me know by giving it a thumbs up. If you don't, let me know by disliking it. I'm okay with constructive criticism, so I won't take it personally. So yeah, I will see you in the next one, which, because I'm bored and got nothing else to do, I will probably be filming another video here right after I get this fixed up. Well, upload it. So, yeah. Have a good Monday.